Hello friends, welcome to my channel Englishpedia. Friends, today we'll be discussing a very famous novel written by Charles Dickens, and that novel is called David Copperfield. So it was published in 1850. It is an autobiographical novel, you all know that. And it is an age of coming novel. It is an Bildungsroman also. And usually Dickens uses so many characters in his novels. So this novel is not an exception of that characteristics, okay? So you have to watch the full video carefully for better and fruitful understanding. So let's start the video. So friends, this novel is started with the story of David Copperfield's life from his childhood to maturity. He is both protagonist and the narrator of the story. He was born in Suffolk, England. He's 6 months after the death of his father, David Copperfield. His father's name was also David Copperfield. David spends his early childhood very happily with his mother, Clara Copperfield, and their kindly housekeeper, Clara Peggotty. So his mother's and his housekeeper's name was same, and that is Clara. Now friends, after his father's death, his mother marries a violent-natured man, Mr. Marston. Both David and Clara Peggotty dislike him. Mr. Marston treated David cruelly, so Peggotty, their housekeeper, takes David to visit her family in Yarmouth. David meets there Peggotty's brother, Mr. Peggotty, and his two adopted children, Ham and little Emily. There, David feels attraction towards Emily. Emily was Mr. Peggotty's niece. When David and Peggotty return from their trip, they saw that his mother and Mr. Marston have been married, and Mr. Marston's sister, Jane Marston, has also come there to stay with them, who was equally cruel to treat them harshly and controlling inhumanly with both David and his mother whenever she was. After that, David is sent away by his father to a boarding school named Salem House, and this school is run by a ruthless headmaster named Mr. Crickle. So friends, there David makes friends James Steerforth and Tommy Traddles. In the meantime, David came to know that his mother dies and David returns home. After returning home, he was neglected by Mr. Marston family. On the other hand, Peggotty marries a man called Mr. Barkis. Now Mr. Marston sends David to work for a wine factory in London. There he meets a good-natured but financially troubled Mr. Micawber family. But this family had to move away from London due to some financial crisis and to pay all their debts. And once they move, David decided to leave as well and tries to find his great-aunt Miss Betsy Trotwood, his only living relative, who abandoned him and his mother at his birth because he was not a girl. He walks a long distance to Miss Betsy's home, and where she lived with a mentally unstable neighbor, Mr. Dick. Miss Betsy sends David to school in Canterbury, and this school was run by a man named Dr. Strong. Now David lives with the family
Mr. Wickfield
Micawber and his daughter Agnes. Agnes is around David's age and will continue to be a significant influence in David's life. So friends, here we will meet another character, Uriah Heep. He serves like a villain in the novel. You should remember this character. He is Mr. Wickfield's servant. Now friends, David, after graduation, he decided to go to visit Peggotty family again. Here David meets his friends Steerforth. From Steerforth, David comes to know that Emily and her cousin Ham is going to be engaged. But both Emily and Steerforth is not happy about the engagement. It seems that Emily and Steerforth like each other. So now friends, Miss Betsy encourages David to pursue a career as a proctor in London. Proctor means a kind of lawyer, and now David meets a lawyer named Mr. Spenlow. Mr. Spenlow one day invites David to his house. There he meets Spenlow's daughter, Dora, a very beautiful but childish girl with whom he quickly falls in love. Later in the novel, he marries Dora, but Dora proves a terrible housewife. She is incompetent in her household works. David loves her anyway and is generally happy. Now friends, on the other hand, as you know, Uriah Heep, who was Mr. Wickfield's servant, makes Wickfield alcoholic. His daughter Agnes becomes upset and sad for his father's bad condition. Even this Heep also wanted to marry Agnes. This Heep was a fraud who made forgery with Mr. Wickfield's signature to defraud the Bank of England. But he is exposed by Micawber and Tommy Traddles, who was David's friend, who have gathered evidence that Uriah Heep committed multiple acts of fraud. However, meanwhile, Mr. Peggotty, who was Clara Peggotty's brother, I have mentioned this earlier, and David comes to know that Emily has run away with Steerforth. Later in the novel, this Steerforth dies in a storm and Ham also dies trying to rescue him. Mr. Peggotty takes Emily to a new life, to Australia. Now friends, what happens next is Miss Bestie's visits to London to inform David that her financial security has been ruined by that culprit Uriah Heep. So David works mornings and evenings under Dr. Strong as a secretary, and with the help of this old friend Tommy Traddles, he learns also shorthand. During this time, Agnes gives moral support to David for his hard work and diligence. David ultimately finds fame and fortunes as an author for writing fiction. So friends, coming to the end of the novel, we see that Dora, David's wife, falls ill and dies. David leaves the country to travel abroad. His love for Agnes grows when David returns. He and Agnes, who has long possessed a secret love for him, get married and they have several children. David pursues writing career with increasing commercial success. So this is how the novel David Copperfield ends.